matatag curriculum, English Grade 4, Quarter 1, Lesson 4, Day 1, Singular and Plural Nouns, and Count and Mass Nouns.
Magandang buhay mga bata! Tara, samahan ninyo ako matuto kasama si
Teacher Aika, your online teacher. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and hit the notification bell for more videos. Thank you!
Hello kids! How are you today? Another day for another lesson in English 4. Our topic is about singular and plural nouns and count and mass nouns. This is Teacher Aika, your online teacher. Let's start! Here are the objectives. Distinguish between mass and count nouns, as well as identify and categorize nouns as singular or plural. Let's have first a short review. Directions: use the pictures below to make compound words. Fire plus fighter is equals to firefighter. Rain plus coat is equals to raincoat. Sun plus flower is equals to sunflower. Dragon plus fly is equals to dragonfly. Sea plus horse is equals to seahorse. Now, can you guess the category of the following? Let's start. What do we call them? Teacher, pupils, guard, janitor, and librarian. We call them persons. Good job! Next, what do we call them? School, church, mall, library, and playground. Exactly! We call them places. Good job! Next we have, what do we call them? Spoon, shoes, books, toys, clothes, pen, and bag. We call them things. Good job, kids! Let's have the next one. What do we call them? Dog, cat, lion, Snake? Wolf? Monkey? We call them animals. Good job, kids! How about this one? What do we call them? Christmas? New Year? Valentine's Day? Holy Week? Halloween? We call them events. Good job, kids! So now we're going to read the story. Then you have to answer the questions. The title of the story is about Rovi Ann's Birthday by Glovic R. Bustamante. Let's start. Rovi Ann is very excited because it is her birthday. The Riliera family will celebrate it on the beach. Mother wakes up early to buy the things needed for cooking food that they will bring to the beach. She goes to the market early to buy fish, fruits, and vegetables. She also goes to the market to buy the things she needs for cooking. When she returns home, she cooks the food to be brought to the beach. Rovi Ann prepares the spoons, forks, and knives. She also prepares the glasses, plates, and saucers in one container. She also prepares fruits like bananas, watermelon, and mangoes in another container. Everything is ready and everybody is excited to go to the beach. They even bring their pet dog, Blackie, with them. Let's answer the comprehension questions from the story. Number 1. Who will go to the beach? The answer, Rovi Ann and her family, the Riliera family, will go to the beach. They will also bring their pet dog, Blackie, with them. Number 2. Where will the Riliera family go? Here's the answer. The Riliera family will go to the beach to celebrate Rovi Ann's birthday. Number 3. What are the things that they will bring to the beach? Here's the answer. The Riliera family will go to the beach to celebrate Rovi Ann's birthday. They will bring cooked food, utensils like spoons, forks, knives, glasses, plates, and saucers, as well as fruits such as bananas, watermelon, and mangoes. They will also take their pet dog, Blackie, along for the celebration. Number 4. Aside from the things that they will bring, what else do they bring with them? Here's the answer. Aside from the food, utensils, fruits, and their pet dog, the Riliera family also brings excitement with them to the beach. Number 5. What occasion are they going to celebrate on the beach? Here's the answer. They are going to celebrate Rovi Ann's birthday on the beach. Now, let us look at these words. Person, Rosa, Mother Reliera family. Place, beach, market. Things, spoons, forks, knives, glasses. Plates, saucers, table napkins. Fruits, bananas, mangoes, watermelon. Event, birthday. Animal, dog, Blackie. A noun is a name of a person, place, thing, animal, or event. This time, we will study the number of nouns. We call them singular noun and plural noun. We will also know the difference between the two. First, we have singular noun. It refers to just one person, place, thing, animal, or idea. Examples: dog, one dog. Book, one book. House, one house. For the plural noun, it refers to more than one person, place, thing, animal, or idea. They are often formed by adding an S or ES to the end of the singular noun. Examples: dogs, more than one dog. Books, more than one book. Houses, more than one house. Regular nouns form their plural by adding S or ES. Let us now study the table 1 below. Singular noun and plural noun. Singular, mother. Plural, mothers. Singular, market. Plural, markets. Singular, container. Plural, containers. Singular, dog. Plural, dogs. Let's have table number 2. Singular, fairy. Plural, fairies. Singular, story. Plural, stories. Singular, elf. Plural, elves. Singular, loaf. Plural, loaves. Next, we have nouns ending in S, SS, SH, CH, Z form their plural by adding ES. Let us now have the table number 3. Singular, bus. Plural, buses. Singular, glass. Plural, glasses. Singular, brush. Plural, brushes. Singular, beach. Plural, beaches. Singular, quiz. Plural, quizzes. Next, we have some nouns ending in O form their plural by adding ES. Let us study the table number 4. Singular, tomato. Plural, tomatoes. Singular, potato. Plural, potatoes. Singular, hero. Plural, heroes. Singular, mango. Plural, mangoes. some nouns ending in O form their plural by adding ES. Singular radio, plural radios. Singular piano, plural pianos. Singular kilo, plural kilos. Singular photo, plural photos. Irregular nouns do not follow standard pluralization rules. They can change forms entirely or follow unique patterns. Let us have table number 6. Singular child, plural children. Singular man, plural men. Singular foot, plural feet. Singular tooth, plural teeth. Let's have an activity. Write the plural form of each singular noun. For some questions, write the singular form of the plural noun. Number 1, dog. Number 2, cats. Number 3, book. Number 4, apples. Number 5, house. Number 6, children. Number 7, shoe. Number 8, mice. Number 9, leaf. And number 10, books. And here are the answers. Number 1, dogs. Number 2, cat. Number 3, books. Number 4, apple. Number 5, houses. Number 6, child. Number 7, shoes. Number 8, mouse. Number 9, leaves. And number 10, book. Good job, kids! This time, let us talk about count and mass nouns. What is count nouns? Count nouns are things you can count individually. Here are the examples. Apple. One apple, two apples, three apples, four apples, five apples, and so on. Chair. One chair, four chairs, many chairs. Dog. One dog, several dogs, five dogs. Book. One book, 10 books, several books. Teacher. One teacher, three teachers, many teachers. Now, how about mass nouns? Mass nouns are things you cannot count individually because they are seen as a whole or a collection. Here are the examples. Milk, juice, sugar, rice, sand. Water, flour, cheese, ice, and batter. have an activity. Look at the pictures and identify if the underlined word is a singular or plural noun. Number 1. The butterfly is very colorful. The answer, the underlined word is butterfly and it is singular. Number 2. The clowns are laughing. The answer, the underlined word is clowns and it is plural. Number 3. My pencil is new. The underlined word is pencil and it is singular. Number 4. The children are dancing. The underlined word is children and it is plural. Number 5. My bag is heavy. The underlined word is bag and it is singular. Our next activity is about fill me up. Instructions. Look at the words below and determine if the given noun is a count noun or a mass noun. Write your answers in the table that follows. And here are the words. Apple, milk, dog, water, chair, rice, book, sugar, car, flower, pen, air, child, sand, table, coffee, house, juice, shirt, and information. Let's have a group activity. The class will be divided into 5 groups and the teacher will give the assigned task to each group. Group 1, you have to write 5 nouns that can be found in the classroom, then write if it is singular or plural. Example, books, that's plural. For group number 2, read the given nouns, then write if it is a singular or a plural noun. Number 1, bus. Number 2, ball. Number 3, churches. Number 4, key. And number 5, children. Number 3, pick out the nouns used in the sentences, then write if it is singular or plural. Example, our class will clean it later. The noun in the sentence is class and it is singular. Here are the sentences. Number 1, she will go to the market tomorrow. Number 2, the children are playing happily. Number 3, the happy baby is smiling at me. Number 4, I walk my dog every morning. And number 5, that butterfly is colorful. For group number 4, read the following nouns and put them under the proper column, count nouns or mass noun. And here are the words, soup, milk, eggs, toy, coffee, cup, salt, sugar, and fork. And last for group number 5, read the following count nouns and mass nouns. Choose the noun that doesn't belong to the group. Number 1, soup, coffee, egg. Number 2, water, apple, and toy. Number 3, vinegar, patis, chicken cube. Number 4, shampoo, lotion, detergent, soap. And number 5, sand rice biscuit. Let's have another activity. Decide if each noun is a count noun or a mass noun. Write count or mass next to each noun. Number 1, apple. Number 2, milk. Number 3, dog. Number 4, sugar. Number 5, book. Number 6, rice. Number 7, car. Number 8, water. Number 9, chair. And number 10, sand. And here are the answers. Number 1, apple. Apple is a count noun. Number 2, milk. Milk is a mass noun. Number 3, dog. Dog is a count noun. Number 4, sugar. Sugar is a mass noun. Number 5, book. Book is a count noun. Number 6, rice. Rice is a mass noun. And number 7, car. Car is a count noun. Number 8, water. Water is a mass noun. Number 9, chair. Chair is a count noun. And number 10, sand. Sand is a mass noun. Good job, kids! And that wraps up today's lesson. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more content like this, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and ring the bell so you never miss an update. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you!